Well, really seriously, since I was 10, but I've had some really crappy cameras over the years. And finally, I got an SLR that somebody gave me because the light meter didn't work on it. So I had to figure out the exposures by looking at the lighting and guessing at the exposures because there was no light meter. Eventually, I got a good camera. I had it easy. I knew when I was in kindergarten and first grade that I wanted to be an art teacher when I grew up because we had this wonderful art teacher named Miss Corey, and I remember her, distinctly remember her. She was this tall, skinny, she had her hair in kind of a bun. She was a character, and I found out I was good at art and I loved it, so I always wanted to be an art teacher. So when it came time to think about colleges and stuff like that, I knew what I wanted my major to be. The funny thing is, I didn't get to take art in high school. We didn't have it. We moved to Indiana. We didn't have art in high school. So I went off to major in art and art education. Got a scholarship to this school, St. Mary of the Woods College, on the basis of my grades and my test scores, and then majored in art. So that's how I became an art teacher. And I was an art teacher forever. And then when we moved here, since I didn't have a job, it made sense to, at that point, go ahead and get my master's degree, because your pay in teaching depends on how much education you have. So I figured I might as well get my master's degree then. So I got my master's degree when Chris was 6 and Derek was 1. So I was running around with 2 babies up and back and forth from Denver to Boulder. It was hysterical, but it was fun. And that's how I got my teaching job, you know. I had worked with some of the schools in Jefferson County, so when I applied for a job there, they hired me. I was doing some shows when I first retired. I was doing more shows, you know, entering more and stuff. And then one day, I think I'd been around here. I've known these galleries forever. And a lot of my friends have belonged to them or still belong to them. And I said, you know what, I'm just gonna see if I can get in the gallery. So I came in and interviewed at this one and got accepted. So I've been a member of this gallery for 6 years now. Of all of the members, it's probably about 25. And the turnover is so regular that I am the second longest one here now. So that's interesting, but it's fun because we've got a whole age range. There's a bunch of us that are around my age that are retired from some other kind of job and doing art now. And there's some that are still in college. So we've got that whole range. It's really a lot of fun. I was sitting at the desk watching my show last year. And I thought, well, I have to decide what I'm going to do for next year's show. And it just popped into my head, I should do food. Because I knew I had a lot of food pictures. And I was going to make books with the food pictures. And I'd been collecting the stuff, like the different placemats. The ones over here have some placemats behind them. They sell these packets of placemats, paper placemats that you can use. And I had those. I had some funny plastic and wooden silverware. I had fancy napkins, I saved stolen menus and other things, and I had all this stuff saved up, and so I just pulled it all out and said, okay, I've got all these crazy frames that I got for $1 or $2 because they didn't have any glass in them. I thought, well, I'm just going to make collages because I don't need glass for those anyway. I just started playing around making them. It's been really fun. It's a lot of fun to do. And it was just like, okay, so I have the birthdays. Okay, I need a calendar. Okay, I need, I had some of the candles that had the numbers, and so I went and bought some more, and then I said, oh, I have to go get the happy birthday letters. I put some bows on there, and you know, it was just evolved. Things just evolved, depending on what I could find. I went over to Michael's one day and spent like $200 on stickers and crazy stuff like that. I was like, oh no, I can't believe I did this. I took some of it back, but most of it I used. It's been fun. pursue photography, learn everything you can about it, take classes, shoot photos constantly, and figure out what's good and what isn't good, and then go from there. And how to make a living at it depends. You know, you can get connections. There's all kinds of commercial photography. There's all kinds of shows you can enter to show your work if that's what you're trying to do. There's a lot of things you can do with newspapers, magazines. Now, all the online stuff, oh my God. We were talking earlier about my niece Eliza. She's got a blog going and she puts her photos on there, and she's got a huge following. I forget what she's got. She's got over 1,000 now. And that's what she's gonna do when she graduates from college. From here, I'd like to keep going with this. I've been debating about whether to stay in this gallery, but I think I'm going to do one more year, just for sure, because I have an idea. Now I'm going to do water next year. That's all I know, water. And the other thing is, the other thing I'm debating about is doing a book from my 45 years of photographing in Colorado, and people are really bugging me to make a book out of that, and a couple of people have said they'd help me with the people who self-published books. But to make a coffee table book of those, and like a chapter for each of like the showcases that I had at DIA, plus more, you know, those categories. So there'd be a chapter for each category with a little story, and then just the pictures with the titles on. So that would be a lot of fun to do. I have to see if I have the energy to do that. But I've done most of the work, so I might as well make a book.